Hello guys, and welcome back to another video. So on today's video, with the new season of the Alliance Conquest coming soon, the season 14, that as you can see in my screen, it's in 2 days and 11 hours for the reset, so your time may be vary depending on what time your Alliance plays, but I digress. The point of this video is how to make your overall experience in the Alliance Conquest better, get the most out of your castle, especially if you're a rally filler and a reinforcement player, or a racer. Yeah, that could work on both cases, because we all know the big rally leads, they know what to do and how to rally and stuff. But of course, the essence of the Alliance Conquest, and as an addition, the Ultimate Conquest that coming after that, it's mostly played by the smaller players, the fillers and so on, because if your alliance doesn't have enough troops to fill the rallies and reinforce the castles, it doesn't matter if you have the strongest and the biggest players in your alliance. So on today's video, I'm going to talk about how to reduce your cost in every match, and how to get the most out of your castle depending on its situation, and of course using your speed ups effectively is one of the most important ways to play this event. So in my opinion, if you are a rally filler and you're not a rally lead, or you're not a player that is going to solo everyone out of their castle, there are some things you should set up in your account. So first of all, I would highly recommend the castle exterior, the only castle exterior right now that gives a big hospital healing speed, and this is the Grand Keep. This is not hard to get, especially with the events that we have from time to time. You can get this exterior from the shop for the season pass, and the Grand Keep coupon here, it costs 1000, so it's not that expensive. It's one pass worth of tokens, and you're going to have some spare as well. So I think this is the strongest exterior for a rally filler and a reinforcement player in the AC season. It's not only for the collection bonus of the army size, but of course for the hostile healing speed that you are going to get on this particular. It starts on 10%, but as you get more and more A tier castle exteriors, it goes up to 22%, which is actually a really big number. Other than that, it's I would suggest that you should change your refinement as well. Going into your refinement page here, and if you go to the all attributes, there's an option here where you can get your hospital healing speed. The hospital healing speed is really good, it's really useful in my opinion. It's not really hard to get, and on its max level, as I said, on its max level is going to be 25%. I'm going to put on the screen my little tab with the refinement bonus on their max. So if you get 25% from one slot, going up to 8 slots, it's going to be a total of 200% of hostile healing speed, which is actually like adding 8 more castle exteriors in your account. But the healing speed buff, it doesn't only end here. Of course, your hospital on your Alliance Conquest is not the same as the hospital in your regular game, so you don't need any capacity on so. So the other buff for your healing speed is going to be on the Sept of the Seven, on the hostile healing speed. These ones are a bit harder to get by, and they're super rare to get those. You only get those from packs from time to time, and sometimes you get them from free, but they're really rare. So I would suggest that you use those only from the time that, for example, it's either you win or lose match that is going to get you kicked out of Ultimate Conquest, or you are going on the top 3 match for the Ultimate Conquest. So most importantly, you should try to use your speeds accordingly to your team. Don't be a solo player. Make sure you see what other people do as well. So if their match is lost, there's no reason to heal your troops. There's no reason to stay on 3 million troops all the time, especially if your team doesn't need them. Managing your healing speeds, of course, is going to be the biggest thing that you can do. Also a small tip that many people are forgetting these days is the elite and normal quests here, where usually there are some boots, the 25% boots, and the speed ups that you can get from those. So try to go for those events when you can, because the race boots are something that are not really cheap to replace, and if you don't have those, especially going forward to the Ultimate Conquest season, it's going to be really bad for you, and especially your diamonds, because the only way to get them in the match is going to be by using blue diamonds. In terms of your armor sets, there's nothing actually that is going to help you out for the healing speed. So the armor sets this time are not really mandatory for this type of tutorial. Obviously you're going to get in a fight with the best thing that you have, the best armor set. This is always depending on your focus, but also something that doesn't count on your healing speed, but really counts for the speed that you are marching, is the Hall of Faces buff that you can get with your account for executing lords. So make sure you have your Hof ready, get your castle exterior ready. As I said, the Red Keep is going to be the most important one to the Grand Keep here. And also, if you are going full on with your alliance and you know that you are not going to be a rally leader, make sure you swap your refinement into healing speed. So I think that's the end of my tutorial for the rally filler player. I'm soon gonna make a tutorial for the rally leads that I know most of them know how to play, but always there are some new people in the game, so they need some more info. So for the rally leaders, it's going to be a different video. So thanks for staying again. I always say that's going to be a short guide, but here we are again, 9 minutes in. So thanks for watching, guys, and I see you on the next one. I'm waiting and always hesitating. Kryptonite desires set my heart afire. Heart on fire. Set my heart afire.